Let's continue with bank reconciliation statement. And in this session, I'm going to take up a question. Here I'll write the question. Prepare a bank reconciliation statement. From the following particulars. As on 31st December 2013, when the passbook balance, when the passbook showed a debit balance of ₹2,500, the first transaction that is given is checks issued for ₹5,000 up to 31st December 2013. Only ₹3,000 could be cleared. Second, checks issued for ₹1,000 but omitted to be recorded in the cash book, right? Thirdly, checks deposited for ₹5,500 but checks for ₹500 were collected on 4th January 2013. Then fourth, a discounted bill of exchange dishonored ₹1,000. A check of ₹500 debited in cash book but omitted to be banked. Then interest allowed by the bank ₹200 but no entry was passed in the cash book, right? Now these are the items that is given. This has to be put in the bank reconciliation statement. Now let's make the bank reconciliation statement first. Bank reconciliation statement as on 31st December 2013, right? So here, first of all, balance is overdraft balance, right? Overdraft balance as per passbook is 2500. Now here I'll write add items. And here I'll write less items, right? Okay. Now let's take up the first one. Checks issued for ₹5,000 up to 31st December 2013, only ₹3,000 could be cleared. That means checks amounting to ₹2,000 could not be cleared, right? So when the checks are issued, the overdraft balance as per the cash book goes up, right? So the overdraft balance as per the cash book has gone up by 5,000. Whereas the bank, in the bank, the overdraft balance has gone up only by 3,000 because it could not collect checks worth rupees. It could not clear checks worth rupees 2,000, right? So the difference is 2,000. In the cash book, the overdraft balance is more by 2,000, fine? So this one should be added. So here I'll write. Checks issued but not cleared, right? 2,000 rupees, right? Then checks checks issued for ₹1,000 but omitted to be recorded in the cash book. Now checks have been issued for ₹1,000, so it might have been cleared by the bank also, So the bank overdraft goes up. The overdraft as per the passbook goes up, but in the cash book you have not recorded it. So the cash book overdraft balance is less, right? So here it will come in the less. Here you will write checks issued but omitted to be entered in cash book, right? So that is 1000 rupees, fine. Then checks deposited for rupees 5500, but checks for rupees 500 were collected on 4th January 2013. So checks deposited for rupees 5500 means the overdraft balance as per the cash book has come down, right? And basically here checks for rupees 500 were collected on 4th January 2013. So as per the bank, the overdraft balance has come down only by 5000 rupees. So the overdraft balance as per the bank is less. Sorry, as per the cash book is less, right? Okay, because in the cash book it has come down by 5500. The difference is 500 rupees, right? So here it should be deducted again, right? Checks deposited but not collected, only 500 rupees you will put here, fine. Only rupees 500 will come. The next one is a discounted bill of exchange dishonored rupees 1000. So when the discounted bill of exchange is dishonored, the cash book overdraft balance will be more, right? Whereas in the cash book overdraft balance will be less. I'm sorry, discounted bill of exchange dishonored rupees 1000. Here the bank, as per the passbook, the overdraft balance will go up by 1000, whereas in the cash book it will be less, right? So this should also be deducted, right? So here I'll write bill of exchange dishonored, the amount is 1000, next one, a check of rupees 500 debited in the cash book. In the cash book you have debited the amount, that means in the cash book, the overdraft balance has come down because you have debited the amount in the cash book, right? The check has been received and you have debited it, but you have not banked it, right? So in the bank, the overdraft balance is still more. In the cash book, it is less, right? So in the cash book, it has become less means it should be subtracted, right? So here you will write check debited in cash book but not banked, right? 500 rupees. Then interest allowed by the bank rupees 200, but no entry was made in the cash book. When the interest is allowed by the bank, the overdraft balance comes down, right? But no entry has been passed in the cash book means in the cash book it is more, the balance is more. So this should be added, right? So interest allowed is 200 rupees. That should be added, fine. Okay, now let's see. This is 2200. So here you write 2200. Add this. This becomes 4700 and the total of this is 1000 2000 3000, right? Okay, so here from this you have to deduct 3000, so 4700 minus 3000 is 1700. 5. So this is overdraft balance as per the cash book is 1700. Fine. So here we can write this is your answer. Overdraft balance as per the cash book, right? This is 1700. Initially, we started with an overdraft of 2500. To that, we added 2200. So the overdraft balance became 4700. And from that, 3000 has been deducted. So it's still an overdraft balance as per the cash book, right? Okay. So this is how this question will be done, right? Hope you have understood this. So with that, I come to the end of this session on bank reconciliation statement. Bye.